Greetings, Water Street Church family. My name is Roberta Vriesma, and I'm grateful to have some time to spend in reflection with you today. Today's topic is near and dear to my heart. The focus is on worship. You may recognize me as part of the third Sunday of the month worship team. So in preparation for today's reflection, I spent time reading and studying the first several chapters of Acts. It's where they outline the growth of the early church. When I'm reading these passages, I have a certain sense of nostalgia that I've missed out on a very beautiful time. Yet it's time that lets me whitewash over the persecution experienced by the early church. I'd like to read these words from Acts 2 verses 46 and 47. Every day they continued to meet together in the temple courts. They broke bread in their homes and ate together with glad and sincere hearts, praising God and enjoying favor of all the people. And the Lord added to their number daily those who were being saved. So I've been reflecting about the early church as part of my expectation that social distancing guidelines are changing and questioning how that's going to affect our ability to worship together. Christians have made the news throughout COVID. The general public has expressed anger that religion and churches are responsible for much of the spread of COVID because of the militancy we have around worshiping together in person. I've had these comments directed at myself. Yet I've also read words from fellow Christians who live under oppression and persecution, and they understand the words of these prominent pastors as judgment, as statements that by not worshiping together, it calls into question their status as Christians. We can call this bad rhetoric of taking statements too far. Yet the experience of judgment regarding worship has also been part of our congregational's experience. I personally have asked myself sometimes if we've been too quick to open because I consider several members of our congregation in the high-risk category. Transparently, I have to acknowledge that my daily experience is in long-term care, and I've had very intimate knowledge about the devastation that COVID has caused in those settings. At the same time, I'm quite aware that there are a number of you that would say to me, "Listen, Roberta, I want and am prepared to come to church no matter what the risk, and that I should not be judging them and let them make their choice," and fair enough. No matter where we sit on this topic, most of us are expecting the restrictions on worship to change. It's going to feel too rapid for some of us, not fast enough for others, and probably uncomfortable for all of us at some level. The question is this: through these changes, can we consider how we navigate our differences? How can we create space for us to walk back into the building we call our church together? How can we be welcoming as we rebuild our fellowship together? I'd like to close with a quote from a book called Amazing Grace by Kathleen Norris. She says, "When people come together to worship, they come as God knows them, with their differences, their wildly various experiences and perspectives, and by some miracle, they sing and listen and pray as one." Thank you for allowing me to spend some time in reflection with you today. Shalom, my church family and friends.